Welcome back, students. In the series of Animal Kingdom, we completed up to the phylum Mollusca, and today we are going to discuss about the third most important phylum of the Animal Kingdom, that is Echinodermata. So, as usual, we will see the special characters which are present in the phylum Echinodermata. What is the meaning of that, and what are the general characters, and what is the classification of the phylum Echinodermata? So here, the most important character which is present in the animals present in phylum Echinodermata is they are exhibiting water vascular system. So what it is, and you there may be a chance of getting confusion between water canal system and water vascular system. Water vascular system is completely different from water canal system, and water vascular system is observed, can be seen in the animals present in phylum Echinodermata, and water canal system we can observe in the animals of Porifera. And these two differences we have to observe. And what is the function of their, we saw what is the structure and what is the function of water canal system, but here water vascular function is it has to helpful for the locomotion purpose. Locomotion, capture and transport of food and for respiration purpose. So this is the functions performed by water vascular system. For example, the example of the animal present here is starfish. Starfish, if you make it inward, we can see the furrows like this, canals. So that is a functional water vascular system of the animal. So here it is helpful for locomotion, transport of food, capture of food, and also for respiratory purpose, because they will accommodate some respiratory organs in the water vascular system. So as a result of that, it is also performing the function of respiration. Okay, this is the most important thing you have to understand in this topic. And what is the meaning of the Echinodermata? That means derma, skin, or the outside body. Echino means spiny. The spiny body, that means this, the outer body is made up of the calcium carbonate or silicon dioxide spicules. So as a result of that, the outer body is looking like a spine and hard. Okay, now we will see the general characters of this phylum. What are the general characters of this phylum? First of all, we will start with the meaning of the name Echinodermata. First one is the meaning is spiny body. Spiny body. And the second one, it is the significance of this phylum. The significance is it is having water vascular system. No other phylum has this one, water vascular system. And don't confuse about water canal system and water vascular system. And habitat, that means where the animals are present. What is the address of the animals here? All are marine except, so these exceptions you have to remember very carefully, except an animal that is Synapta. Except Synapta. This Synapta is present in the brackish waters. So what is brackish water? For example, this is a sea or ocean and this is a river. River is going to merge with the sea. So here at this junction, the water is slightly saline. not more than the seawater, and it is more than the fresh water. That salinity is there, medium range, because here the fresh water and the seawater is mixing. So that place is brackish waters. So these are present only all are marine except the animal, that is Synapta. It is present in the brackish waters. And symmetry, this is also very important, you have to know here. All are bilaterally symmetrical, so they are exhibiting bilateral symmetry, but the adults are pentaradial. Already we discussed this in the symmetry topic. Pentaradial, that means the body can be cut into equal halves by using five different planes, but the axis is one. Okay. And coelom here, it is also exhibiting true coelom, but what is the true coelom? Enterocoelom, not cytocoelom. Cytocoelom is up to Annelida, Arthropoda and Mollusca, but here it is also a type of true coelom. It is formed from the archenteron pouches. Already we discussed in detail when we are discussing the coelom chapter. And the cytocoelom is formed from the splitting of mesodermal blocks. Now, the levels of organization. Levels of organization, it is exhibiting organ system level of organization. Organ system level. From nematoda onwards, they are all animals are exhibiting organ system level of organization. And here, number of germ layers. Number of germ layers, it is exhibiting triploblastic level of germ layers, three layers. Segmentation here is absent, as like in the molluscans, segmentation is absent. The process of digestion is extracellular. That means the process of digestion occurs inside the alimentary canal and the nutrients only enters into the cell. And respiration here, different types of special respiratory organs are there. They are very important, you have to understand. Papulae, dermal branchiae, peristomial gills, and respiratory trees. These are the different types of respiratory organs present in the animals. Not all the organs present in one animal, some group of, because it is a vast classification is there. So each animal shows a respective type of respiratory organs, but exam point of view, no need to know about the classification of the phylum Echinodermata, because in our NCRT they didn't mention. So these are the different types of respiratory organs: papulae, dermal branchiae, peristomial gills, respiratory trees. All of these will be accommodated in the water vascular system. That's why it is also playing an important role in the process of respiration. Now we will see the remaining characters like blood vascular system, and also like excretion and so many like that. So, the circulation. circulation here is closed blood vascular system. Sorry. Open blood vascular system. Open blood vascular system. See here, only annelida is exhibiting closed. Arthropoda open circulatory system. Mollusca, except the class cephalopoda, all are exhibiting open type of circulatory system. And but the class cephalopoda is exhibiting closed type. And echinodermata, all are showing open type of blood vascular system. And here the process of excretion is, the excretory system is absent. So it will be done through simple diffusion, because the excretory organs are not there. So the waste materials will be gone out through the process of simple diffusion. And nervous system here is circum oral nerve ring. See here, we have seen circumpharyngeal, circumesophageal nerve rings. But here, the nerve ring is surrounded the mouth region, entire mouth region. So it is known as circumoral nerve ring. Here, now, sense organs here is statocysts. So we have to know in how many phylums the sense organs, statocysts are present. They will ask which of the following phyla are having the sense organs, statocysts. They will give multiple options. Annelida, Arthropoda, Echinodermata in one option. Nidaria, Tenophora, Platyhelminthes in one option. Like that. Or they may ask by giving the examples also. That will be much more difficulty. Okay, so you have to write at one place where the organ, sense organ statocysts are present, in which phylums. And the sexuality, mostly these are unisexual. Reproduction. These are exhibiting sexual type of reproduction. Fertilization. External type of fertilization. That means they need the medium. That is, mainly they are present in the marine water. So water acts as a medium of fertilization. And the final character, that is development, which is indirect development. So here we are not discussing about the classification, but you have to know the different types of larval forms. It is very important in the exam point of view. So I am giving you the list of larval forms present in different types of classes which are present in the phylum Echinodermata. So the first larva is Dolio Laria larva, Pentacrinoid larva, Bipinnaria larva, Brachiolaria larva, Ophioplutus larva, Echinoplutus larva, Arcularia larva, Doliolaria larva. These are the different types of, already mentioned here, different types of larval forms which are present in different subphylums and the classes of the phylum Echinodermata. So it is purely your wish. If you want to know, you can know. Otherwise, you may leave it. But I have to tell these things. Dolichocephalic larva, pentacrinoid larva, bipinnaria, brachiolaria, ophioplotus, echinoplotus, and auricularia larva. These are the different types of larval forms, because it is mostly exhibiting indirect stage of development. Okay, and the statocysts are very important here. Water vascular system is very important. What are the functions of the water vascular system? For respiration, for locomotion, to capture the food, and for the transport of food from one region to another region. These are the different general characters exhibited by the animals which are present in the phylum Echinodermata. Now we will see what are the animals present in this phylum. Examples. What are the different types of animals present in the phylum? First one is, as you know, everyone knows that starfish. Its scientific name is Asterias. Asterias, starfish. Echinus. This is only containing Echinoplotus larva. Echinus. Sea urchin. Echinus, sea urchin. Antidon. Antidon. Sea lily. Its common name is sea lily. And Cucumeria. Cucumeria, sea cucumber. Sea cucumber. Ophiura, that means it is exhibiting Ophioplotus larva. Ophiura, its a common name is brittle star. Brittle star. So these are the different types of animals which are present in this phylum. Asterias, that is famous, we know, the starfish. Echinus, that is sea urchin, Echinoplotus larva. Antidon, sea lily. Cucumeria, its scientific name is Cucumeria, and the common name is sea cucumber. And final one is Ophiura, its common name is brittle star. So this is about the phylum Echinodermata, and I hope you are doing well, and I hope you have completed the work which was given by me. That means you have to maintain a chart. So if you completed up to Mollusca yesterday, you fill the same general characters in the Echinodermata column also. If you don't know, again, I am giving you the idea in this class also. So how it is, all the phylums will be in this one, and all the general characters will be in this column. So Porifera, Cnidaria, Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, and Hemichordata. And here, general characters you can write. Take a big size paper, not A4, it will not be sufficient. So here, the general characters. For example, the first character, the term coined by. Term coined by. So here in the Porifera, the term coined by Grant, but we don't know Cnidaria, Ctenophora, so make it like this. Wherever you know, Annelida was given by Lamarck, it was given by Grant, so leave it. Okay, and go to the next meaning of the phylum. I think all I have meaning. So Porifera having pores, Cnidaria have nidoblasts, Ctenophora have comb plates, Platyhelminthes flatworms, Nematoda roundworms, so like that. And significance, so like that. I had given almost 20 or 21 general characters or 19. So fill entire list, and today Acheron Dermata was over, so fill in the Acheron Dermata column, and if you didn't do the work or previous work, you fill in these columns also, and send me through your send me to my WhatsApp. Okay, and tomorrow we will see the phylum Hemichordata. As that, we will finish the entire invertebrates. So to all the phylums are really completed. So from the next class onwards, we will go for vertebrates. What are the different characters which by which we are considering, we are deciding that animal belongs to vertebrates or chordates? All these are non-chordates. We are starting from day after tomorrow, chordates, that is fish, amphibia, reptiles, birds, mammals. So there are five classes in the phylum non-chordates. Okay, so prepare well and we will have an exam. So take care. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can text me and you can also call me, so we can clarify your doubts. Thank you so much.